now. And that is, you know, to tell the truth, that is the reason why the level of joy is so low. That's the reason why the level of enthusiasm and excitement is so low, because we do a pretty good job in thinking, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, my soul cries out. Till your soul cry out, hallelujah. Until your soul begin to what? Express itself. Yes, I will rejoice in the Lord. From the rising of the sun till the going down of the same, I will make my boast in the Lord. Bible says the humble will what? Hear, and they will be what? Glad. Amen. So you gotta what? You gotta say stuff if you want it to become life to you. Amen. You know, Sister Hill, before she mentioned that Rodney had a Bible that he really cherished. A little Bible. It was real small, with a button up, a zip up. He really treasured it. And one day he lost it. And he lost it in, what did he lose that Bible?
He was out of town
somewhere. And he lost it, and this is what Rodney said. He said, I'm going to get my Bible back. Sister Hill said, oh boy, you know you're going to get that Bible back. It was way, way away somewhere. And Rodney kept saying, I'm going to get my Bible back. My Bible, I'm going to receive it back. I'm going to get it back. He said it about 5 years, and one day, true enough, that Bible came in the mail. Somebody had found it, and the man that found it, name was Rodney. Rodney had his name there. And he what? Put it in the mail and shipped it. Got his Bible back. Kept on what? Saying. That's very important for you to what?
Yes.
Keep saying. Hallelujah. All right, so it's important for us to say what God says. Okay. Now, look down at Proverbs 12:6. The mouth of the upright shall deliver them. Okay, somebody give me an illustration. The mouth of the upright shall deliver them. The mouth of the upright shall deliver them. All right, anybody can bring that out? The mouth of the upright shall deliver.
That's what you say. Finding the word what's relative to the situation.
There you go.
And you keep speaking that, meditating on that
until
it comes into
right. Coming into reality. All right, so that is, now, the scripture, Sister Deborah, you just made a very good explanation of that. Isaiah 57:19 says, I create the fruit of the lips. Isn't that something? The devil just said it. He said that. Just keep saying it. And God said what? I'll create the fruit of your lips. So the mouth of the upright shall what? All right, now, does that mean financially too? Okay, show me, tell me how it will deliver you financially. Tell me how it can deliver you physically. Anybody? Now, it was a few days ago, someone called us, and this person was speaking about, she said that there's a possibility that, I might be coming down with an irreversible sickness. I might not be living much longer. See, when you hear people talk like that, you always want to direct their attention back to the long life scriptures. You want them to be directed toward what? Healing scriptures. And we got tons of long life. Long life. And the Bible promises you that if you fear the Lord, walk in His ways, you will not be visited by death. You will not be visited by evil. And that's true. So you have to, how many meditate on long life? How many want long life? Let me just ask. How many want long life?
Yeah.
Everybody want to live a long time?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, now, Psalms 91:16, it tells you how you can live a long time, with long life. With long life, I will what? That's what 91:16. Okay, with what?
My salvation.
With long life, I will what?
Satisfy him. Show him my salvation.
Okay. God said with long life, but it's a verse above that that probably gives you some things that you have to do. What does that verse say? 15, yeah, okay.
He shall come upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him.
Okay, okay. But
all of this, because he has said his love.
All right, see that? Because he has what? Set his love upon me. Therefore, I will what? Okay, I will deliver him. So, that entire chapter, all, if you want all of those good things to happen to you, is contingent upon that second verse that we started out with. I will what? Say. I will say. Now, let me show you what I use for people that have been diagnosed and the doctor has given them an unfavorable outlook. Here's a scripture I use all the time, and it really encourages people that hear this. Blessed, Psalms 41, it says this, blessed is he that what? Considereth the poor, the Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. The Lord, I think that to mean that people that are faithful to God in their tithing and their giving, this is the best way that we help the poor in the kingdom of God. We teach people the word of God. Whenever you support the ministry and the kingdom of God, this is the best way to give to the poor. Because if you're just out there handing out food every day, are they going to take it?
Yes.
And they'll be back when?
Tomorrow.
Right? But if you really begin to what? Gradually teach them and get the word into them, they will begin to what? Have their